Saving your data using the JSON functions is more popular than ever due to the significant quality of life improvements made in GameMaker Studio 2.3, specifically the ability to use structs and arrays to save data. But as a result, I've recently seen a number of questions on the GMC forum about debugging JSON save issues. I generally save using the JSON format, and I've run into many of these same issues, so I'm going to share my process for debugging them. But before I do that, a brief disclaimer. Saving large amounts of game data is inherently at least a little bit complicated, and it requires a basic understanding of several different types of data structures, conversion of data structures, and file systems. And that's just to save and load the data. You still need to tie all of that data into your game, so you can have errors at many points. And what I'm going to cover here really is how to debug the save process itself to make sure that the data you save out is the data that you get back. Also, this tutorial assumes that you already have a basic understanding of how JSON functions work. So let's get started. Step one, review your GameMaker data in the debugger. Do not use show debug message. You will not get the information that you need using show debug message. Use the debugger. Make sure you know what your data looks like before you save it. And if you're using maps and lists, remember to view that data as a map or list. Your goal at this point is to verify that your data looks as expected. Step two, check the string returned by JSON stringify or JSON encode. Again, use the debugger. Don't use show debug message. You want to be able to compare it to your game data. This string is human readable, so you should be able to inspect it and verify that all of your prior data has correctly been converted into a JSON compatible string. If the string is too long to read in GameMaker, you can always copy it and paste it into some type of online editor. I'll show an example later. Step three, save this string as a string and check the file. Now, the most watched JSON saving tutorial on YouTube at the moment is Sean Spaulding's. In this tutorial, he converts the string to a buffer and then saves the buffer. And there's nothing wrong with this, but while you are debugging, don't do this. Save it out as text because the text is human readable. After you fix any errors, you can add the buffer line back in. But while you're debugging, while you're building your save system, save it out as a string. Your goal at this point is to verify that the string you inspected when you converted the data to a string has saved to the file correctly. And again, if this string is too long to read, you can copy and paste it into a JSON editor and format it there. Step four, load the string in and inspect the string in the debugger. Your goal at this point is to verify that the string in the save file has been loaded and unchanged. Again, you can copy and paste to a JSON editor to inspect it if there is too much data to read in GameMaker. And essentially, you should notice that steps 2, 3, and 4 all deal with the string, and in every case, that string should be identical, should be unchanged through each step. Step 5, use JSON parse or JSON decode to turn that string back into GameMaker data. Inspect the result in the debugger. Again, use the debugger, not show debug message. Your goal at this point is to verify both that the string you loaded in has been correctly converted back into a GameMaker data structure and that the loaded in data structure is the same as the saved out data structure. These 5 steps allow you to inspect the data at each transition point and confirm that what you think is happening is actually happening and that data isn't being changed or lost as part of the process. Now, let's jump over to GameMaker and walk through a very short example of these 5 steps. This is a slightly modified version of my JSON project, and there's a link to the GitHub repo down below. I've already run the debugger, and we stopped on this line. The first thing we can do is inspect my saved data. Now, this saved data is fake, so I can't properly do step 1. Obviously, what is down here is going to reflect what is up here. But if this were your game, you would want to make sure that this data is what you think it should be. Now, as of 2.32, structs now contain these internal methods, such as toString, but you can safely ignore them. They won't be saved out. Next, we're going to step into the JSON save function. This will look familiar if you've watched my JSON tutorials. We're going to open the file, and then we're going to turn our JSON data into our JSON string. There are 2 things I want to note here. First, to help with the debugging process, I actually made a slight change to my code. Normally, this script execute line is just right here, but so that I could see what was happening, I broke it into 2 parts. And this is a good thing to keep in mind. Sometimes if you are having a problem, it can be a good idea to write your code a little bit more verbosely with a few more extra steps so you can walk through it and see what is happening at every step. Once you've debugged it, you can always put it back into that more compact version. The second thing I want to point out here is that if we inspect this string, even if we add wrap, it's still a little bit hard to see. And this is very short. If there was a lot more data, it would quickly become unmanageable. but we can copy our data and bring it over to some free JSON formatter online, paste it in, process it, and here we go. If we compare this to our GameMaker data, we can see that we got exactly what we expected to. Now we can save this to a text file. I can bring the text file over, I can open it. Where these files are saved depends on your operating system. In Windows, it gets saved in my user directory under app data, then local, and then the name of the project. Now we want to compare the string. This one, again, is simple enough that I could just look at it and validate it. But if your data was more complex, you might want to copy and paste it into some type of editor, process it, and again, we get the same results. Now we want to move on to step 4, loading the data back in. So we're going to come in to my load function, and rather than just go through all these lines, I'm going to advance to the next breakpoint here. We're going to close the file, and now, again, we have our JSON string. This is what we read in from the file. We can inspect it and once again see that it is the exact same. And of course, if you had any questions, you could put it into some type of JSON editor again online. Now we move to the last step. We have our loaded saved data. We can both verify that that string got loaded in correctly, and more importantly, we can confirm by comparing our two data structures that the data is identical between the data we saved out and the data that we loaded in. Of course, this process only tells you how to spot a problem. It doesn't tell you how to fix it. Now, finding the problem often is enough to fix it, but sometimes it won't be. And while there are many ways something could go wrong, here are two common problems that you might run into. Problem number one, data corruption between step one and step two. If your data changes when you convert it from a data structure into a JSON string, then it likely means you are trying to save some non-JSON compatible data. So make sure to review what data is and is not JSON compatible. Problem number two, not marking internal lists and maps as lists and maps. This problem isn't an issue with structs and arrays, but if you are still using lists and maps, remember that any list or map added to a list or map has to be marked as such. Otherwise, all that is saved out is the list or map reference, which is just an integer, not the actual data contained in that list or map. This should be pretty obvious if you're inspecting the data as you go, as all of the data held by the internal list and maps will disappear in between steps 1 and 2. So there you go, a 5-step process to ensuring your data's integrity and a few common problems that you might encounter. And of course, if you want more videos on using JSON in GameMaker Studio 2, including an entire sample project, check out these videos.